Movies about the American frontier always fascinated me, especially those with stories about trappers and traders and explorers of the high plains and the mountains. I imagined living in that huge wilderness of another time, pristine and still populated by native people and animals. The adventurers of film and history carried little more than what was essential for their survival, including a good rifle. And the quintessential rifle, at least in my imagination, was the Hawken 50 caliber. Several years ago, my brother Joe sent me a present. It was a Hawken 50 caliber rifle kit with a maple stock, octagonal barrel, and brass fittings. Yeah, it was just like one I built a long time ago. I remembered the many hours I spent sanding and polishing and finishing each piece. It took several weeks to complete, and for a teenager, taking the time to do it right was a real challenge. Not long after, I left for the army, and that old Hawken disappeared. Enclosed with the new rifle kit was a letter from Joe. Once upon a time, he wrote, "You assembled what I consider to be a magnificent St. Louis Hawken rifle. Whatever happened to that work of art is a mystery," he said. "Ever since, I have wanted to give you the opportunity to work your magic again." This unexpected second chance was exciting, so I immediately laid out the disassembled wood, brass, and steel parts on a table. I started a mental inventory of the finishing supplies I would need, and I thought about every step and every technique I would use to recreate that old Hawken. Why so long? Lack of time, mostly. But there was another problem. You see, the first Hawken had been the product of focused creative energy. It was a one-time work of art, or of craftsmanship anyway. And I didn't feel the same inspired motivation to simply create a copy. So I had to find a way to make the new Hawken surpass the first one somehow. But how? The inspiration came first from the photo of a rifle with a richly carved stock. I knew nothing about relief carving, but I was determined that this Hawken would be adorned with carvings. So I would spend a few months learning the rudiments and experimenting with various relief carving techniques. The second wave of inspiration is what set off the final sprint for the finish, although it had nothing to do with the Hawken's appearance. The first rifle was only ever displayed on my bedroom wall, and although I had collected some of the loading equipment, I had never fired it. This Hawken was going to be beautiful and functional. You see, a Hawken is a muzzle-loading firearm. The powder and the bullets are loaded through the front or muzzle of the barrel. Learning how to properly load and shoot a primitive firearm is an achievement in itself. A couple of months later, the Hawken was finished. Oak leaf and floral carvings on the left side of the stock provided balance to the decorative hardware on the right side. The maple wood gleamed almost as much as the highly polished brass. By then, I had everything I needed to fire the Hawken. my son Chris and I met with a gunsmith student whose family had a private shooting range. It was January, and although it was sunny, there were patches of snow and an icy wind. Without the benefit of experience, the loading process took several minutes, and there was a little anxiety setting up that first round, not knowing for sure if it was done correctly. Finally, after checking and rechecking everything, the only thing left to do was to squeeze the trigger.
Yeah.
Okay. We'll even
let's see what you got. Let's see if you can hit the target this time.
Of the actual loading process. All right, caps on.
Patrick Roos firing his 50 caliber Hawkens rifle.
That is a hair trigger.
What do you think?
The climactic moment was better than I imagined. Even with a modest load, shooting the Hawken 50 caliber is like firing a small cannon. The loud crack and the significant recoil were accompanied by more smoke than modern firearms. Also, the black powder left a more distinctive cordite smell, even more so due to the cold, dry air that day. And a single shot made the barrel very hot. Although it is a working firearm, this Hawken will likely be more of a mantelpiece than a hunting rifle. But like those Hawkens of old, it is a prized possession, valued for its beauty and as an icon of personal history.